say that. Whoever put it off.
My name is Nick Servini, I'm the political editor of BBC Wales. Don't worry, I'm not going to talk politics. I'll be introducing the events tonight, and we are in for a real treat because behind me, as you can see, we've got over 100 singers, and I'm told you really have to go into the mists of time to get a mass choir like this in St. Elvan's Church, the main church in the Pelenna Valley. So we really do have something to look forward to. I don't think they need much by way of introduction, but a few words on the four choirs that we've got behind me, and we've also got the Mackie Brass ensemble as well, which we'll hear from tonight, and maybe I'll say a few more words on those as the night goes on. We have the Cwmbach Male Choir, obviously. I have to say, when you look at the description of their achievements over the years, it is an incredible reminder of all the happiness they brought to so many corners of the world with their singing. And as they march towards their centenary, they'll be joined tonight by one of the kids on the block, Cwmdare Voices, formed 5 years ago, bucking this quite sad trend about so many choirs closing around the country. 40 voices, clearly they're going to Hanover, I know, later in the year, a young choir going places. They're also joined by Pelenna Valley Male Voice Choir, started in 1980 in Tom Brown, and in the programme, it says that they're the only choir to have sung in the Marian devotion at the Basilica of Montserrat. They also have a very close association with Catherine Jenkins, who used to be there at a lot of their concerts. I'm sorry, boys, you have to put up with me tonight. And last but not least, Mountain Ash Rugby Football Club singers. Now, in 1974, when most people go to Scotland on the Rugby International, they come back with a hangover and an empty wallet. This lot came back with a plan to start a choir, and they're here, and they're obviously still going strong. So, a big round of applause for the four choirs we'll be performing for you tonight. Joining them will be the organist William Thomas, the accompanist Jayne Thomas, and of course, last but not least, the musical director for the evening, Dr. Mike Thomas.
right, I'm going to shout then, right? So get the first bit out of the way now. We will be singing Fuddlon, and the next song we're going to sing is Let It Be You. And we're going to dedicate this to you in the audience who make our lives worth living. Everybody behind me here now has got somebody out there that loves them. So this is a little song dedicated to the people who make everything worthwhile.
It goes like this, the fall down.
out Welsh song, a Welsh hymn, Morte Christi, when I survey you under this cross. And we'll be joined for a round end, hopefully, by Mackie Brass on the last verse.
He was described as Mr. Cwmbach
or I particularly like the description as the Alex Ferguson of Cwmbach Male Choir. Anyway, the point I want to make is when I was growing up in Aberdare, a lot of the kind of backdrop to my childhood was all the talk of Cwmbach Male Choir, all the chat, you know, the internal politics that goes on in every choir, how the tenors were performing, how the second tenors, all seem to be issues with the second tenors. Sorry, that could be my memory playing tricks with me, I'm not sure. But in a way, you know, forget politics that I'm covering now. The real politics was the internal politics of Cwmbach Male Choir. You grew up with that, you can deal with anything, I suppose. But actually, the main point I wanted to make was the sense of, and it'll be the same for all the choirs, not just Cwmbach, the other choirs as well tonight, an appreciation that I've got, I'm not in a choir, but I have an appreciation of the huge commitment that all these men put into performing, or what a huge part of their lives it is. Right, Mackie Brass are ready to go. They are all students at the Royal College of Music and Drama. I'm going to tell you a bit more about them in a minute, but the intriguing thing is that they were set up specifically or with tonight in mind.
Good evening, we are Mackie Brass, and we're going to be starting tonight with Trumpet Vulgary by Jeremiah Clark. Thank you.
Thank you.
Carmen. This arrangement features three key tunes, which is the Habanera, the Torero song, the famous march with the bullfighter at the end. We hope you enjoy this medley from the opera Carmen by the Rodriguez.
Great rousing in the world. tonight that will make you laugh and songs that will make you cry. And this is a sad song. We often remind us, this song reminds us of people who have passed, no longer with us. And it's a beautiful arrangement of Softly, I Will Need You.
Thank you.
when you have back to mainstream stuff now with the Male Voice Choir, there's a fantastic anthem from Chess.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
tone that we're allowed to raise between £3,000 and £4,000. Stars of the show, Cwmbach Male Choir, Cwmdare Voices, Pelenna Male Choir, Mountain Ash, Football Club Singers, and they are, of course, accompanied by Jayne Thomas, William Thomas, and the organ, and of course, our musical director for the evening, Dr. Mike Thomas. Now, I mean, get one of these.
You feel like heaven to touch.
social media, our friends on Facebook. Is it Alana here tonight? Ask Sir Jay. Well, we've learned this song now, especially for the even though they're not good, you know if we sing it anyway. live music, people on this side over there are the same way these people on the side over there, and everybody on this side are going to sing with these people over there. We'll start first, sing a bit, then they sing a bit, and then we all want to sing it together. It's a contrapuntal film. Is anybody expecting the one for the moment? So, you know, most of you know it, it's got an idea singing and there's no one there.
Thank you.
ordinary of this week after his death. One was he was in North Strip meeting a delegation from the Zulu community, bearing in mind the sensitivities and the swords that went on there, wearing of all things a Welsh rugby jersey. No one was really sure I was right at the time. Now this was remiss of me at the start, but I'm going to name all the members of Mackie Brass. Joe Thomas and Corey Morris on trumpet, Joe Arkwright on trombone, Andrew Humphreys on the French horn, and Pete Greenwood on tuba, because we're going to get some more of them now, as you can see. And I've thought for a long time now that all good things come from the pub. Because Mackie Brass, the idea for it came from the boozer.
Thank you. Thank you.
Their mum or dad had a stroke, and that's what I do with my day to day.
releases. It gives me a great deal of pleasure. I get some very unusual requests, so as you can see, I've got curly hair. It makes my hair very curly when they say something. Can I get back to doing that? Now I don't want to talk about it. Like you, with the men singing, I moved to speech and language therapy. And I realised 20 years ago, and it's very common now, about people with dysphasia, communication difficulties, following their stroke, that they can get back into that they could speak, but they could sing. And the pleasure they got out of that was amazing. Now, the other half of my job is that I work at Cwmdare. So anyone that has a stroke in Cwmdare, I could come across, and once again, I'm up there giving information and advice. The organisation provides information, leaflets, we do research, and I'm very proud of what we do. We both are going to the hospitals and then follow those people back into the rooms with different requests. And one that I was asked just about 2 or 3 years ago was a nightmare. She was an 89-year-old lady, and she said to me, Steph, she said, before I die, she said, we had a stroke, she's quite paralyzed on one side. She said, I want to dance in the arms of a young man. I thought, right, how am I going to deal with this one? So I applied for a welfare grant to look for a teacher that could do it, and I managed to get a teacher for good. And she's still dancing today, and she dances a lot.
For tonight, now this one may not enter. Thank you.
I don't think we get any more sample. We're going to finish with an Eric Trilogy, which is very, very good. We might sing another one. Lots of love to people in the fans. I think they get to be fabulous tonight. I'm sure that there's a gift, but I would like to thank my partner. organised this with me over the last song, and it's a very special relationship. It's probably got the best set of our names in the voice for this one. So we're looking forward to seeing this. Big thank you to see everyone for accommodating us tonight. I think it's been a great success for the church and for us as well. So I'm very grateful for those. And for the boys, my friends again, and the beautiful stage, which we'll be dismantling tomorrow. So it's been a big effort, but I really think that we've enjoyed it now as much as we have in Aberdare. So.
Thank you.
June events. What a fantastic performance. We've had a full range of people there. I've never been in St. Edmund's Church before, and we're brought up looking at this fire, but I feel really privileged to be here tonight to hear such a magnificent concert this evening. So I think just one more time, if you could show your appreciation to the
cracker. Cracker, I thought.